What's up, folks, and welcome back to the garage. Today I will measure the Saab's valve adjustments, and I try to fix the oil leak between the valve cover and cylinder head. I have been quite busy here in the garage. Yesterday we fixed a Hecas daily, Renault, and there was a small brake service, but that's the whole story. Greeting also to Heka. He is the tall guy who is fixing the Saab with me, and we own this 50-50 this car. The Volvo project is going on. Last video you saw that I fixed those and put those front brake calipers on, and the windscreen frame is okay, and actually I have the rear brakes here. I got a message from Scandix that they don't have these anymore, or actually they told me that nobody manufactures these anymore, these kind of brake piston. So I took the pin off, and now I can use this kind of piston, so no worries, I can put these together. But before that I need these new brake lines for the front brakes, so I will fix the whole brakes in the same time. It will take a few days to get those new hoses, but this project is going on also. And my wife's car is still in the garage. It's waiting for the new rubbers or new boots for the drive shaft, but they should be here in any minute or any day, so I can get this car ready and out of the garage. And if you follow this channel in Facebook or Instagram, you know already that I'm opening the web store with a company called Tarrapaita. And there will be at least one t-shirt, one hoodie, cap, maybe two kind of t-shirts, but I'll let you know later. This valve adjustment check is actually quite easy. I just take the distributor cap off and those cables off, and then this valve cover off, and after that it's quite easy to measure. We are lucky to have this official Saab service manual. We have actually quite many of these files, and this is much more accurate than normal service books. There's almost everything in this manual. It says here, it's in Finnish, but there's these measurements with the intake and with the exhaust valves. But this engine is not a stock, so I don't know if these are valid anymore, these measurements, but it's important to measure that all the gaps are the same, so then we know that it might be possible to fix this engine problem just adjusting the valves again. But if this doesn't help, then we might have a bigger problem. Cover off, and it's actually quite easy to measure You can see the camshaft. When the camshaft is in this position, 180 degrees from the valve, this cup there should rotate, as you can see. Yeah, it's not tight. And I have a chart, professional-like. Okay, there's a mistake there. This gap between this cup and camshaft should be in this range. So this tool, this should go there and this shouldn't. So if this goes and this don't, then we know that the adjustment is right. So let's do a quick test. I put this one there, and as you can see, it fits perfectly. And then this one don't go there at all. So now we know that this valve is okay. So now I just put the third gear on and rotate the engine so I can measure the next valve. And now I can put the mark on my chart board. Now I have rotated the engine a little bit, and as you can see, the fourth cylinder exhaust valve is now totally open, and it should be between 0.35 and 0.5. And actually, I don't have a 0.35, but I have done my math, 0.2 and 0.15, so totally. So this should go there, and this 0.5 should not. So let's see. This goes there and fits perfectly, no problem, just tight enough. And then this 0.5, not a chance. So this valve is okay too. And now I just repeat this thing like still six more times. Okay, and as you can see, all the valves should be okay. They are in between those measurements. So the problem is not the valve adjustment. This was a little bit bad news, but I will try to figure out what's the wrong with the engine. And before I put this valve cover back, I just check it straight, because this is quite thin material, so it bends quite easy if you tie these bolts too tight. So I have to check it totally straight. It's not actually, so I have to tap it very carefully. So after that, it should be okay. I know that I should use a new gasket, but this one is quite new, so it should be still okay, because I remember that when we changed this with Heka. So I will go with this old one. Thank you. the valve cover is on, and as you saw, all the valve adjustment are okay, so that's not the problem, so I have to keep looking. In next video, I will check the timing with the lamp, and then I will also check the pressures from the cylinders. I just have to try different things to find the what's wrong with this engine. Don't worry, I'll be back soon, and thanks for watching, and see you soon.